Welcome to our online service. I'm Augustine, and I'm on staff here at St. James and Emmanuel Disbury in Manchester. We are an intergenerational, multicultural, vibrant, inclusive Anglican church. Whoever you are, no matter your background or whom you love, you belong here. Let's begin with a prayer before we worship in song. Heavenly Father, thank you for making all things new. As this year begins, help us to live each day for you. May we continually have a new song in our hearts to sing to you, no matter what comes our way. We trust in you because we know that your mercies are new every morning, and nothing ahead of us will take you by surprise. In Jesus' name.
Praises rising, eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for you. When we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Hear the sound of hearts returning to you. We turn to you. In your kingdom, broken lives are made new. You make us new. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna. All our fears are washed away. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Come have your way among us. We welcome you here.
Today's reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, and is about following Jesus. Throughout John the Baptist's ministry, there was followers or disciples who were learning from his teachings. But at the baptism of Jesus, they began to follow Jesus. The Gospel we read to us by Hillary, followed by a reflection from one of our lay readers, Ray.
The reading today is from the Gospel of John, starting chapter 1, verse 29. The next day he saw Jesus coming towards him and declared, "Here is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, 'After me comes a man who ranks ahead of me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel." And John testified, "I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it remained on him. I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, 'He on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit.' And I myself have seen and have testified that this is the Son of God." The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. This is the word of the Lord.
Today's reading is in two parts. They span 2 days. In the first part, John the Baptist recognizes Jesus as the man he baptized in the Jordan. The man who went into the water human and came out divine. "I saw the Spirit," said John, "descend on him like a dove, and it remained on him." And we could think of the Spirit as dove representing a new beginning, as it does in the story of Noah. As Catherine told us in last week's broadcast, Jesus did not need to be baptized as repentance for sin, but that he might be revealed, that God might declare him to be his Son in whom he is well pleased. After 30 years of wait, Jesus then begins his ministry. And this is emphasized strongly at the beginning of St. Mark's Gospel. The dove descends. At once, Mark writes, that same Spirit pushed Jesus out into the wilderness for 40 days and nights to be tested, but also to come to terms with and plan for God's mission and ministry on earth. But John the Baptist didn't stop there. Job done. No, the next day he declares to anyone who would listen, he is God's Passover lamb. Two persons who did listen were disciples of the baptizer himself. They follow Jesus to where he was staying and spend the day there listening to his teaching. The first disciple disappears from the story. The other is named Andrew, He went and fetched his brother, Simon Peter, Cephas, the rock. Thus, in small steps, God's kingdom starts to build. 2,000 years on, the building continues through each of us with our own unique discipleships.
I believe in you, Father. I believe in your Son. I believe in the Spirit, three in one. All honor and majesty belong to you. I will praise you in all that I do.
I know you're my helper, I will not be afraid. I am your creation, so wonderfully made. All honor and majesty belong to you. I will praise you in all that I do.
Nothing can separate me from your love. No barrier or barricade is strong enough. I worship you and give you thanks for all you have done. The sacrifice of your only Son.
I have tasted your goodness and have drunk your new wine.
Help me live out my life by your will, not mine. All honor and majesty belong to you. I will praise you in all that I do. Nothing can separate me from your love. No barrier or barricade is strong enough. I worship you and give you thanks for all you have done. The sacrifice of your only Son. I have tasted your goodness and have drunk your new wine.
Help me live out my life by your will, not mine.
All honor and majesty belong to you. I will praise you in all that I do. All honor and majesty belong to you. I will praise you in all that I do.
John shouts out as Isaiah's voice in the wilderness. Andrew hears. He tells Peter. Then, if we read on, Philip follows next. He goes and brings in Nathanael. In this way, by encouragement one-to-one, the initial team of 12 is built. Today, the team is counted worldwide in billions. We at St. James and Emmanuel regard you who tune in each week as one of our congregations. But what can we in all six congregations we support do to help build the Christ's team further? By making more disciples. The Bible tells us we shouldn't worry too much about doing it. God has given us all the tools we need. Just keep a lookout for opportunities as they present themselves. As someone formerly involved in team building in a commercial context, one story I can relate to is that of Stephen. In chapter 6 of the book of Acts, the 12 apostles choose Stephen to be team leader to set up what might be called, in a modern context, a food bank. Stephen didn't see this as a put-down, a menial task, but as an opportunity to fulfill his own ministry. And we know where that's led. His later martyrdom was witnessed by Saul, a Pharisee steeped in the law who became Paul, whose conversion spread the good news over most of the then known world. Bringing people forward, giving them a responsibility, can lead to who knows where. Paul himself opens his first letter to the Corinthians, and I paraphrase somewhat, "May all the gifts and benefits that come from God and the Master Jesus Christ be yours. There's no end to what has happened in you. You don't need a thing. All God's gifts are right in front of you as you wait expectantly for our Master Jesus to arrive. God, who got you started in this spiritual adventure," he writes, "will never give up on you." What encouragement to that church and to us 2 millennia later. And it all started with one telling one, who told another, who in turn told another. Ecclesiastes verse 12 of chapter 12 tells us that constant study wears you out, so you're no good for anything else, which I suppose could be translated in modern speak as just do it. I'll finish with a short prayer. Christ's are our lips, his words we speak. Prophets are we whose deeds proclaim Christ's truth in love, that we may be Christ in the world to spread Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you, Ray. Jane will now lead us in prayer.
Let us pray to our wonderful God, Father, Son, and Spirit. Lord our God, reveal the power of your love in this damaged and troubled world. We ask, as Jesus taught us, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where nations plan for war or are trapped in conflict, while Christ says, put up your sword, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where countries waste food and covet luxury, while Christ says, I was hungry, I was thirsty, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where powerful governments claim their policies are heaven-blessed, while Scripture states that God helps the powerless, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where Christians try to make the kingdom in the shape of their own church, as if Christ had come to build and not to break barriers, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where women who speak up for their dignity are treated with scorn or contempt, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where men try hard to be tough because they're afraid to be tender, your kingdom come, your will be done. Where our prayers falter, our faith weakens, our light grows dim, shine your light on us. Your kingdom come, your will be done. We hold before you everyone who is suffering because of war or conflict. Everyone who's struggling with need for the essentials of life. Everyone who is ill in body, mind, or spirit. God, just as you showed the wise men your powerful love in a helpless baby, show us your love working in unexpected places and unexpected ways. You set aside your glory to be born as a human. Break through our pride, our fear, and our complacency, and work in us and through us. Show us where and when and how to give our gifts of love and service to you, so that we can help in the work of your kingdom. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Amen.
Let's draw our prayers together with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great is our God! And all will see how great is our God. And age to age he stands, and time is in his hands. Beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead three. Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great is our God! And all will see how great is our God, is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great. How great is our God.
Thank you for being with us today. We really value you spending your time with us and also the encouraging feedback that you share. Let's finish with a blessing. May grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Amen. Now go be the church.
Isn't it good to be as one, living in perfect harmony, sharing the good things God has done, God has done. Oh, isn't it good to be as one, living in perfect harmony, sharing the good things God has done, God has done. Oh, isn't it good to be as one, living in perfect harmony, sharing